Water is responsible for all elements of life, and it is our responsibility to preserve and protect it.
So everybody, sorry I'm late, I had to blow a few red lights to get here, but my name is Mayor Rahm Emanuel, for those of you who don't know me, and today we're going to talk about issues of water and wastewater in Chicago and how can we improve. So if anybody would like to open up the opening question, we'll do that now.
I have a question, Mr. Mayor.
Okay.
Recently there has been some speculation that with all the pollution happening, it can affect our water quality and then top of our soil water. Do you think this is stoppable?
It's definitely not stoppable. I mean, water pollution is something that affects everyone around the globe, but it is something that we can improve on and try to do the best at. Chicago does a very good job with their purification system. We have one of the best systems, you know, in the nation. But we're always looking to raise our standard. That's why we implemented a new team at our metropolitan facilities to increase security, to ensure that there's no littering, there's no unauthorized persons entering the premises to contaminate the water in any way. And we're going straight directly to the companies that are responsible for the runoffs that pollutes our water. That way everyone in Chicago has access to clean drinking and water for whatever use that they want. Good question.
If we don't control our pollution, Lake Michigan will look like this.
Recently in Chicago, basement floodings have been happening more and more during heavy storms. And as far as we know, it has something to do with too much water in our sewer systems. So my question to you is, are there any plans to manage this stormwater?
Sewers that are, you know, almost 100 years old. And with these new engineers that we have worked with, we're making and designing new ones that could catch more water at a higher rate to avoid flooding in the residential homes or in the business.
On April 13th, 1992, 250 million gallons of water flooded the Chicago Loop area, costing the city $68 billion in damages.
We painted the picture you want.
Since water is a resource that is used on a daily basis by all individuals, it is important to keep this incredible resource. What are your plans on increasing the water usage in Chicago, and how do you think the mayor of San Diego is dealing with
it? The mayor, a new plan that I plan to implement is monitoring 50% of accounts that have access to Chicago water, meaning that so it's either you or somebody else in any neighborhood, half of the city that has access to Chicago water will install a meter and will monitor their accounts and charge those account holders accordingly. And I know, you know, a rise in the water charge is never, you know, a good thing to, or happy thing to hear, but it's good for the environment and it's good for people using it because it avoids, you know, like wasting water and stuff like that. So people can be more conscious about when they actually turn on the faucet. So in the end, in the long run, it's a good thing, and we need to implement it to preserve our water. And we plan to bring it down by 2%, which is 14 million gallons per day that we would be saving with this new 50% account monitoring. So
1 in 9 people worldwide do not have access to clean and safe drinking water.
The Chicago River, the second waterfront of Chicago?
The city limits. Any individuals or companies that are willing to start businesses along this coast here will receive tax breaks and easier access to city permits and to city buildings and things like that. So it's almost in a way a partnership with the city, because we want to bring this this waterfront neighborhood together.
The Chicago River is 156 miles long and passes through more than 22 neighborhoods in Chicago.
So the main point of this is water is our biggest resource and it's a resource necessary for life. New York's water system that they have, they also have a similar system to ours. New York has fairly good standard for drinking water. They also use desalination, taking salt from the ocean and doing that, aquifers, rivers that they have.
The average precipitation in New York is 90 billion gallons per day, or 40 inches per year. Still sipping my Tide, sitting courtside, Knicks and Nets give me high five. I be spiked out, I could trip a referee, tell by my attitude that I most definitely from
New York.
Surrounding states of Lake Michigan, the five Great Lakes. So Wisconsin, Michigan, Indiana, all the states that have access to this body of water. Different states have different laws, but we're working with those states to just have almost one set of laws and one set of way to handle Lake Michigan and the other lakes. That way the quality of our five Great Lakes is standard all across the board. So I thank you all for coming, and everybody drive safe, and thank you for being here.
I want to dance by water underneath the Mexican sky, drink some margaritas by swinging blue lights, listen to the mariachi play at midnight. Are you with me? Are you with me?